I've disassembled the seat that I'm going to move to the front passenger position. This is the seat that was originally in the right side middle row stow and go. And right now I'm cutting this bracket off of the seat. That's a bracket that's made for securing child seats, you know, baby booster seats and whatnot. And I'm never going to carry any infants in this van, and I don't want to be sitting on that thing when I'm in the front seat, so I'm cutting them off. The upholstery is pretty easy to put together. It's held in place by these clips all the way around. I didn't unhook it from the front, but it's got it. Those two hooks in the back there, and a big one in the front. The same on the other side. Then there's a screw here, and a screw here, and a screw here that holds the plastic piece into place, and this bolt right here and this bolt right here holds the upright to the seat base. Alright, I put the seat in the folded position and reinstalled the black bolt and the silver bolt that you see there. There's two on each side. You can see where they stick through the seat on the inside there. On the right side plastic cover, there's a screw there. There's a screw right there. And then there's two screws inside of this cup holder that hold this plastic trim on, and then you just have to locate it on that tab in the front. On the other side, it goes together pretty much the same, except there's only two screws. The one in the back right here and the one under the pivot right here. So the left side plastic is easier to install than the right side. This lever, which activates the mechanism, is held in place by this little locking tab right here, and that thing just slides on there like that. I gotta use two hands to put that on. Let's try this again. That lever right there that works the action, you have to put this plastic cover on before you install the side cover. And it just slides into place and clicks. And then now it's stuck by that tab. Also, these two slots right here and right here, those hooks in the bottom of that thing have to go in there before you try to put these two screws in there. That's another thing I did wrong the first time I did it. Now that I got that thing hooked in there the right way, it just snaps right shut. I'm using this seat instead of the original front seat is because of this bolt pattern right here. This bolt, that bolt, this bolt, and this bolt have very close to the right dimensions for the Northern Tool seat pivot kit. This measures 10 inches by 10 inches, or to the rear, it's 13. I believe that kit is 12 inches by 13 inches. So if I use the front bolt and the back bolt, I can cheat these in a little bit and use that one. The original front seat was like way too big. You can see it up there. I would have never worked on that seat pivot. Now, unfortunately, I do not have the Northern Tool seat pivot kit yet. I have to, it's like 80 bucks, so I gotta save up the money to buy that along with a bunch of other stuff for the van. Alright, I have the seat just resting on the front seat bracket. I'm gonna have to raise that up in the back and level it out by welding on some pieces of metal on the back. I'm gonna make it out of square tubing. I got some 1x1x8 square tubing, which is about how thick that metal is over for the original bracket. That'll raise it up a little bit and flatten it out so that when it spins around, it spins pretty flat. So that center console is gonna have to go so I can spin that chair around when I want to. I was planning on getting rid of that anyways because it's really not that useful, and it's in the way if I want to get in the back of the van from the driver's seat or the passenger seat without getting out of the van. So if it's raining and I need to move, or, you know, there's lots of reasons why you would want to go from the front to the back without getting outside, without having to hop over that thing. One of the things that I really like about this van is that it has a 3.8 V6, and you can get a trailer hitch for it, and I'll be able to tow my dirt bike behind it pretty easily. It'll have enough power to do that and still get, you know, relatively decent gas mileage. One of the things I dislike about it is it's not a Westfalia Volkswagen. Westies are what really got me into camper vans in the first place. My uncle had one when I was a kid, and he lived kind of far away, and I never actually got to go camping in it. I was always kind of jealous of my cousins for how much time they got to spend in that thing. His was, I think, like a 82 or a 84. It wasn't the old microbus style. It was the next newer one that was a little more square. It had sort of like a little diesel engine in the back. But one of the things that I do like about my van is it's not a Volkswagen. Volkswagens, they don't seem to have that much power, and it seems like guys work on them a whole lot. So ultimately, I would like to have a pop top, maybe not on this van, maybe on the next one, just to have headroom and stuff. But this van is going to have to work for now.